Hi guys, good evening. Welcome back to my channel. My name is Liz. I'm cooking and at the same time I want to pick a story. I think when I move my camera, my lens keeps on moving. So let me try focus in one area. So there's this story on Tuko. There's this story on Tuko that I watched about this boy, Akisema. His teacher was telling him to go to the forests. Just because he had this dark skin. Imagine, it is so mean. It is absolutely so mean. After Bible and Assembly, we're all made in God's image. So you can imagine when you want to go to the forest where your other baboons are, and it's say, and as a matter of fact, that thing can affect your performance. I remember there's a time I was dating this person. Hey. You try to put on these clothes, you know, sometimes appreciation and compliment to mtu. Namwambia, you looking good, this dress looks good on you, this hairstyle looks good on you. Imagine I used to tell him, how do I look? And I would be, hey, kuna dem kwa TV alikuwa amevaa hivi anakaa vizuri. And to some point, before I realized it, my self-esteem was going low. And you see, it was getting into my mind, like, this person, I'm not good enough. You can never be good enough, but you know he's not appreciating you. See, and then he tells you, you tell him how do I look in this hair, and he tells you, ata ungenyo ungeka vizuri. You know, mimi siyezi sipendi mademu ameshuka. Na wewe ndio uko naye hapo, but he's like, napenda mademu shorti. I'll just give you 200 bubu ndio ukanyoe. I mean, and there and again, my self-esteem was getting so down, like ilikuwa na ndege chini kabisa. Hey, and it took me time to realize, like, after moving on, I really had issues. Still have issues. Yes. So, back to the story. This man. Wantuko, mwalimu alikuja akashinda akamwambia, you look like you should be in the forest with your other monkey. Your relatives. Of course, they're like monkeys. But how can you tell another person that you're like a monkey? Ama anafaa kwenda kwa msitu. It is so mean. I watched the story. It was so touching. Walimu kubuli wanafunzi. Tafadhali tuwache. Tafadhali mwache. Because you can imagine if you're a medic and then you start selecting patients. Unasema, I'm not going to attend to these patients. Ako hivi. Like ni mchafu. Ama ni nunu. Ama ni mkonde. You are killing this person. Slowly, you're killing this person. This person will fall into depression. This person might even go ahead and kill himself or herself. Sasa mwalimu shule, kuna huyu mwalimu alikuwa tu shule, yani mwalimu alinichukia. And I remember there's a time my dad told him, hey, just leave my daughter. Even if he gets an E, he is my daughter. Nothing beats a parental love, honestly. Because he was just too much on me. Mwalimu alikuja class. I don't know, ala nashangaa wana sito kuna hizo maths. Anakuja class, anakuchuna na kalamu. Unajuleza, sasa nimefanya nini? Ini? And then after class, he comes during prep time. Oops. He comes during prep time and then he calls you. Nabiswa, fulani. He could just shout your names out and then tells you, follow me. You follow him to the staff room. The next thing ni viboko. Yeni, unatu kabisa umwalimu anakuchukia kabisa. And he could just pinch you out of nowhere. He comes, he passes your desk. Then we used to sing, I know I can be where I wanna be. If I work at a cheat, I'll be where I wanna be. But now you are pinching me. How will I be where I wanna be? Unashinda umenichukia, umenichua, umenifanya takataka zote kwa darasa. So, the good thing came, pure transfer. Hey, sijui ni maombi ilijibiwa ama iliponi. I think it was just like an answered prayer. My friend, I was happy because before that, I remember the time I told my mom, hey mom, mimi nitataka ku transfer kwa hii shule. And my mom told me, umeishi ukipanda hii shule kabisa. And do you know the story why you even... It was my very first selection in school. Nilichuzio shule na nilikuwa nimeipenda. You can imagine you are young. Class 8 of course, bado tukua dogo, 14, 13 hapo. You are very young. And then when you go to town, or you pass these girls wearing those nice skirts, just stand there. And my mom told me, you know, when you're born, that's when our school is in transition. And she's like, why you chose St. Joseph? It was something that just started Jana. You chose St. Joseph because when you are born, I was having these complications, you are this premature baby, capitan. That means like you are not confusion 39, 38, 40 weeks. I was not yet there. And there's a girl who came as St. Joseph's girls, the Sashule Manzishwa Evi. There's this girl who came and she just carried me. And I remember my mom telling me, this girl told me, Ebuka Groka kuje shule. I pray that she grows up and comes to our school. How could Nilianda, you know, the power of the tongue, the power of, is it confession or something? That's where I went. So my mom told me, intro ndiko nataka. Now, I don't know how we loved it, because when we're still, yeah, like, kizaliwa hivi, there's a lady who carried you. And she was like, she hopes one day he'll join that school. So, usijali, ilifika mahali, my grades were dropped. Actually, were dropped. My grades dropped. Like, literally dropped. I'll be back. My grades literally dropped. There's a time, I think I got an E in a cut. And I'm never ashamed of that. Because I'm not now the E. Because umalima ngekuja darasa, the best thing you could go to sleep and not even wish like morning to come. Because the first thing is a bit asubu, you know what comes in the morning. Those morning subjects. Then, he was the class teacher. Being a class teacher ngekuja class anytime kuna free lesson in nini anakuja class. Ushajua akikuja class, the first thing anapita kwa desk yako ni kukuchuma. It was so bad. So my grades dropped. And he told, so kulikuwa na academic. For that cut, ile katoni katoto opening school na kila kitu. Unafungwa shule kwa nile stress ya. Again, facing this teacher who hates me. Who doesn't like me. Honestly, he hated me. And others. Unaenda shule, unafungwa hivi cut, unafanya, unadonda. I got that cut, E. But, I'm not the E. Imagine, ushaipata E. Like, iyo wakati singesema, but saizi nitakwambia ukweli. So, and he, during that academic day, lucky enough my dad came. My dad is like, you know, being daddy's girl, you know, like being the daddy's girl. My father came, because my mom and he could get me roast and they side na huyo mwalimu. So if my dad came and he just told me, even if he gets an E, he's still my daughter. And my father told me, you're not an E person. And I know you'll never get an E. Just wake up from this. This is not you, this is not your dream. I know you can do better. Because of course I was like, this is good. What happened? Really, when you form two wakati, you know, form two kwa ile stage ya kusumbua kabisa. Lakini siko nasumbua. So, parental advice ni mzuri. So, huyu mwalimu akafanya nini? Ikafika form three. Hey, I think it was just good. Because, trust you, if this teacher was still in that school, maybe the highest grade I think I could have gotten must be a similar or something. The highest grade in the pata. Sabu unakadarasa hivi, hauna amani, mwalimu anakuchukia, anakuchoma. Makosa kidogo kidogo unakuja class. Uja make noise, but the best place to jipata ni kwa list and noise maker. Na utatandikwa. So you keep on being sad, like in that sad mood and everything. Sasa, mwalimu akapigwa transfer. And I think it opened my eye. It honestly did. I was happy. And the class teacher you were given, he solved controversy in peace because his death came as a shock to most of us. He just got an accident, died on spot. This mwalimu who made me believe in myself again. And he was like, Nabiswa, this is not you. Read. Go back to your notes. Do your assignments properly. This is not you. And then he asked, nataka kukua nini? Kambia, mimi, nataka kufanya kosia medicine. Like, yes, you can do it. You can, and I know you will. And he died minus me, minus him knowing, like, tulifanya tulifika hapo. So tukapo na huyu mwalimu, tukapush na yeye form 4 nini, he was the best teacher for us. I mean, he was this year, could tell your parent, this student has the potential. This one, huyu atapita. Just trust in him. You know, and those kind of things. So self-esteem, mental health, mental issues, we should never, you know, sometimes when I say mother will leave me a kitu kidogo lakini, it can just tear one apart badly off. So imagine if this mwalimu was still in school, mimi nigepata hiyo. Because he told me at one moment, the highest grade you can get is a E. Sijui kama kuna grade ingine chini ya E. Like, anafanya na kuchuna. Tana shangaa mbona sina hizo marks za kuchuna. Atakuwa anichuna. The worst thing nilikuwa naka at the edge of a row. But alienda. We met at one moment in a hospital, in a certain place, to do attachment. And then he saw me like, hi teacher, I'm the E student here. Then he tells my senior CEO, this is my student, student. Nikambe, yeah, but she never got an A. At least she tried. Like, yeah, I'm happy for you. Stop pretending. Let's be considerate of other people's feelings, emotions. Let's not be hurting people. Imagine anza kuchoose patient na sema huyo si mtibu, huyu ni jaluo, huyu ni mluya, huyu ni mnono, huyu ni mfupi, huyu utampatia dawa za kumeza, akitaka aende utampatia dawa za sindano, utampatia intravenous or oral. It's on me. So, that's the story. Let me go back to my chapati cooking. And remember to subscribe, turn on the post notification bell. And guess what? I'll see you on my next video. Until then, keep safe. Remember, health is worth. Lazy Lab, this way is out. We're feeling the COVID first, so tafadhali tujichunge, tuvae a mask na nitaonana na nyinyi katika video yangu nyingine. I'll see you. Goodbye.